Today on The Four, with the spread of the Delta variant, more bars and restaurants are taking action. The vaccine requirements they are now considering to protect their staff and prevent their businesses from getting shut down again.
From KTVU Fox 2 News, this is The Four.
And welcome to The Four. Today I'm Jana Katsuyama in for Heather Holmes.
And I'm Alex Savage. The weekend is almost here and a lot of people might be looking for a night out on the town. But in San Francisco, that may mean bringing proof of vaccination along with you. KTVU's Christian Captain joining us now live from Teeth, a bar in the city. And Christian, some bars and restaurants are saying in addition to carding for age, they'll also be checking vaccine cards as well this weekend.
Yeah, Alex, Jana, you know, this is a Friday night. This is one of those nights that a lot of people are either going to be going out in San Francisco or coming in from out and surrounding areas into the city for a night out. Like you said, some bars and restaurants already have procedures in place where they're asking people if they've been vaccinated. But starting next week, a lot more bars and restaurants might ask for that kind of verification before you go from an outdoor setting like this to an indoor setting like that, and they're going to require either some proof of vaccination, either you can bring your vaccination card or perhaps a PDF. This is something that a lot of businesses are considering. Bars and restaurants are considering making this shift. And again, the city is saying that they are behind this idea. They are supportive of the idea because they want to see more people getting those vaccination rates. Remember that we have started seeing an increase in COVID cases in San Francisco and in some surrounding areas because of the increase of that Delta variant. So now might be one of the most critical times to get those vaccines in arms. This might be yet another way of trying to encourage people to get those vaccinations.
And Christian, for the business owners, the bar owners that you spoke with here, what was the motivation for them to put these requirements in place to have people be fully vaccinated
right
if they come inside?
That's right. And we've seen some bars and restaurants that are already doing this, Alex. But we talked with the head of the Bar Owner Alliance, and he had said that really his motivation is trying to protect those bar workers. He's saying that he's already starting to see some bartenders and bar workers who are testing positive for COVID. And fortunately, their symptoms are relatively mild because he says most of them have already been vaccinated. He says a lot of that is coming because of people who are either unvaccinated coming into bars. So a lot of bars are going to be taking a vote. They'll be deciding as early as next week as to whether they're going to require all of that. And we did have a chance to talk with the Office of Workforce Development in San Francisco. They said that's an excellent example of how private businesses can be leveraged to do public good. The head of the Office of Workforce Development saying that she thinks it's very important that these businesses take this step to try to ensure that more people are getting vaccinated. San Francisco's COVID positivity rate has been steadily increasing over the last month. Now some restaurants and bars are saying they will require customers to show proof they've been vaccinated before being allowed indoors. Ben Blyman from the San Francisco Bar Owner Alliance says 300 or so bars are set to make a formal decision next week about requiring proof of immunization.
And so we're making a decision. We're going to make it next week, but we're going to decide on whether or not all of the bars together in the San Francisco Bar Owner Alliance are going to recommend that they require proof of vaccination or a 72-hour test, negative test, to enter any bar.
Unvaccinated customers will still be allowed in outdoor areas, but the Bar Owner Alliance says some bartenders and workers indoors are already starting to see breakthrough COVID infections, even though they're vaccinated. The bar is saying while it may encourage more customers to get vaccines, they are making the move to protect their workers and their workers' families.
If people get convinced because of us, great, but this is not a moral stand we're taking. This is us looking at the data and saying we need to protect our staff now before it's too late.
Some restaurants are following suit. Gozu in the city is advising customers as they book reservations that they may be required to show proof of vaccination. The Golden Gate Restaurant Association released a statement saying while they support the Bar Owner Alliance, it would be impractical for many restaurants to do the same. But they did say, quote, "We will continue to follow and amplify the guidance of San Francisco and regional health officials with a focus on the strong need for vaccinations. We recently strongly recommended that our members follow the new indoor masking recommendations issued July 16th. The head of San Francisco's Office of Economic and Workforce Development saying private businesses like bars and restaurants can amplify the city's message, urging workers and customers to get a vaccine.
The idea of employers incentivizing their own employees and customers to be vaccinated is really about our small businesses helping themselves stay in business and being part of our community to overall, you know, try to step up.
Blyman from the Bar Owners Alliance said with vaccine requirements likely, he's ready for any potential backlash.
Let's be really clear about this. We don't care about the first pushback. The worst they can do is not come to our establishments, which is exactly what we're asking them not to do.
And while there are no formal plans for a so-called vaccine passport to be issued by the city of San Francisco, the city is encouraging as many people as possible to get vaccinated, including requiring city workers to get immunized. Reporting live in the Mission in San Francisco, Christian Kaftan, KTVU, Fox 2 News.
All right, Christian, appreciate that. Thank you.